There it goes, and there's Kyle.
Hey, Kyle.
Hey.
We are recording.
Okay. The May 12th, 2021 Board of Appeals hearing is in session, so we start with a roll call.
David Kraszewski.
Here.
Kyle Lombardo.
Here.
Jim McWhirter.
Here.
Ron Roki. He is out front. Tommy Willis.
Here.
And Tricia Hatley.
Here.
All right.
I believe all members have received copies of last month's meeting minutes. Are there any comments, concerns, or corrections for those meeting minutes?
I'll make a motion to approve.
We have a motion. Do we have a second to approve?
Second.
I'll make a second. Let's vote individually since we can't. All in favor? One at a time? Yes.
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 I'll abstain. I wasn't at the meeting.
Okay. Meeting minutes are approved. First case today is BOAB 2021-00002, the appeal of Mark Zitzo with Johnson & Associates LLC from a decision of the code official for noncompliance with Chapter 6, Section 602.1, and Chapter 7, Section 705.8 of the International Building Code 2015, as adopted by the City of Oklahoma City, pertaining to the required fire-rated separation walls and allowed openings in exterior walls at 811 Northwest 72nd Street. Do we have the applicant, or are we going to go without him today?
Tim Johnson's on. I'm the applicant for this case.
Oh, okay.
Mark just made the application, but he's on vacation, so
great.
I'm stepping in. So we were before this board a couple years ago with the first building out on Wilshire Point that needed this appeal. And the purpose of it is we are using these, it's kind of a self-storage use unit with a little bit of a twist in the PUD that allows it to have a restroom and facilities and air conditioning. And so they're commonly referred to in the real estate market as man caves. And these are for sale units. And really basically people store their expensive cars. They do their hobbies in there. And so the placement of the buildings create the backdrop to the whole addition that's along the railroad tracks east of Class and south of Wilshire. If you can recall, the railroad tracks come to a point where Wilshire and Classen meet. So we are now getting ready to start building two. And so we are here before you asking for the same appeal that was provided for the other building. And if I can share my screen, I can kind of show you what we're talking about. As soon as I can find the little pointer, there we go. So can you all see my screen?
Yes.
So this area is considered Wilshire Point. It's a planned community. We have single family detached housing. We have offices, we have multifamily proposed on the Classen side up north. And then this whole band, as you go along the railroad track, is set to be more of these condominium buildings. So obviously the aerial and the property maps don't line up, but we're technically we're a foot off of the right of way. And so the BNSF has an extra wide right of way through here that currently only carries one track. We don't ever see a building ever being built in here, and that's kind of the basis of our appeal, is that We don't believe that this will ever be anything but a railroad track, maybe a multiple railroad tracks, but there's never going to be a building built within that right of way. And so we're requesting that the appeal based on the application. And I'd be happy to answer any questions.
Tim, I understand this case was reviewed before. I think it was January 9th, 2019. I unfortunately wasn't at that case, so I'm going to ask some questions that may were answered before. With that BNSF right-of-way, what's the width, total width of the right-of-way? Do you know offhand?
I want to say it's 150 feet. But let me check.
Okay.
No, it's actually right at 200 feet.
200 feet. Well, I went up the site and took a look, and what was revealing to me and added credence to your request was the substantial ravine between your building to the east and the railroad track. There's quite a deep ravine there. You being a civil engineer, would it be likely that my concern is that they would start building closer, developing, even though it was a BNSF right-of-way, developing railroad lines closer to your building. Would it be likely that they would not try to move into that ravine area, or would they, and they would build to the east of the existing track? What is feasible or likely for further development in that BNSF right-of-way?
Sure, that's a great question. So we did talk to the railroad several times up and down this track, because we were involved in this development over here as well. And to your point, there's a little bit of a bar ditch here, but nothing near as deep as the ditch on our side, which we have respected. It carries a ton of water to this point, and then here it backs up and actually goes over Wilshire. The structure under the railroad track is not big enough. So this is carrying all their drainage from 63rd Street North. And so in order for them to develop that, they would have to cramp that with their ballast and to get the spacing on the tracks. So they've not committed to ever adding another track, because we've asked them. And in fact, we just got a quiet zone approved for Wilshire and Classen, and that'll be going to construction, which restricts by putting in islands in here, it restricts the tracks to where they are now, single tracks. And that's been approved by BNSF, and we're waiting on it to go through Oklahoma City's process, and then it'll get built. So to answer your question, the likelihood of an additional track at all is not on their radar. If they were to build one, it would be cheaper for them to build it to the east. But in this amount of right-of-way, they could put in 10 rails and still fit in there.
Okay. What is the occupancy use group of this building? I assume, Scott, that it's an S. Tim, do you know how it was permitted? Or Scott, can you lean some credence to how it happened?
Yeah, that'll be an S1 use.
Yep, that's what I was recalling.
Okay, and the look like they're insulated panels, and I think your letter describes them as insulated panels. Can you describe what type of panel is used specifically on the east wall?
It is to my knowledge, it's a 1-hour insulated panel.
Okay, so it's a steel panel with some kind of foam in it, and the steel gives you the 1-hour rating, I would assume.
And I'm pretty sure it won't show up on Street View here, but it's a flat panel butted together is kind of the look.
Right. Yeah, it's reminiscent of a cold storage panel that I've seen. Look with the steel skin on it. Okay.
Right.
Okay. And you're wanting to put some windows in, and I think that your statement says that you'll be at a maximum of 7% of the wall area on the east wall. Is that correct?
That is correct.
Okay. And there is a statement that says something about, maybe Scott, you can help me clarify this one if Tim can't. This would be at 8% less than the otherwise permitted for a development of this nature. What does that statement mean? That's it. It's confusing to me.
So if we had 10 feet of space, we could go to 15% on that wall.
Okay.
But you know, building on the right of way there, 1 foot from the right of way, you wouldn't be allowed no openings. Is that right?
That would be correct. But we do have, you know, the exceptions. There is a supplement written into the code that does allow for the distance to be measured at right angles from the face of the wall. The building official may accept a common lot platted easement or other dedicated right of way. This is not really necessarily a right of way, but perhaps could be considered similar to a platted easement.
Right. Yeah. We've for the new board members, we've looked at cases like this in the past where they were private right of ways, or even in the urban settings that they were parking lots, and we've approved them. And some of them we use stipulations, being say like a parking lot, and I think it might be reasonable to do it on this one, that if there are any changes in the adjacent property, be it a parking lot or a public right-of-way, that the applicant or the building owner, not necessarily the applicant in this case, the building owner would come back to the building permitting department for review, and if needed be, but could come back to the Board of Appeals if the building department deemed it a need to be heard at the Board of Appeals. So that's kind of the presence we've set with these kind of, and I feel that this one is definitely within the realms of approval with the idea that this is a private right-of-way that is unlikely to be developed further. And if it was, that the owner would have to come back and do what the building department and or the Board of Appeals would deem appropriate at that time.
We'd be agreeable to that stipulation.
If there are any more questions from the board or comments from the board, if not, I can make that a motion. Tommy, you want to chime in from the fire protection side?
David, your the statement about coming back if somebody was to ever want to build there, basically coming back and reevaluating it, that addressed the concern that I had. Okay. is in the future. So if we do that stipulation, I really don't have any concerns.
Now here, there's one stipulation on that makes it not quite as clean as I said, but I think that there's enough mechanism there to make it happen, is that the triggering for the whoever the current building owner is to come back would be on them doing that on their own accord, or the city having knowledge of this one and connecting the dots on it too.
Yeah.
So there's a little bit of, you know, will it happen? But I think with on something of that scale, I think that the folks, if it's BNSF, would be looking at it. The city would be looking at it. Planning would be looking at it. Zoning would be looking at it. So I think there would be enough eyes on it, probably more than a parking lot, when we did the urban stuff downtown, would give us likelihood that the eyes would get on it, and it could be re-reviewed with changes in that right of way.
Have we not in the past actually required permission from the adjacent owner? I mean, because in a way you're restricting their property. Have we never actually had?
I can answer that.
Okay, yeah, I think so.
No, we haven't, because when we make the stipulations, generally the stipulations are indicate that if there anything's constructed, then our owner will have to comply.
Right.
So, you know, and most of the time we're talking about in urban settings, we're talking about buildings that are built right on the property line that do have already 2-hour walls. Mm-hmm. They just want the openings. So they have to brick in their openings. Should somebody build within, okay, you know, 5 feet, for example, it would have to be 2 hours within 10 feet, you know.
Okay.
That's true, but there are also cases that we've heard where there are existing openings and there may be a change of use, which requires them to get a new permit and bring things up to code, and then therefore they're out of compliance, though the building could have been built in the 20s. Right. So some could be, you know, the desire to open new windows, or some could be existing windows, and we've allowed both of those, right, in those reasons. Any other questions, concerns from the board? I'll make the motion to approve the variance with the conditions that if any development happens on the adjacent property, that the building will be brought up to code, and that if any development is done, that they will come back to building department, and at their discretion, come back to the board if required.
Second. That was Jim. Second. Scott. Sorry.
Scott, when you're ready.
No problem. I've got it. Go ahead. So David Krzyzewski?
Yes.
Okay. Kyle Lombardo?
Yes.
Jim McWhirter?
Yes.
Tommy Willis?
Yes.
And Tricia Hatley?
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you all.
The motion is approved. Your variance is granted. Thank you.
Thank you.
So that includes our case for today. That's short and sweet. Do we have a motion to adjourn?
I'll make a motion to adjourn.
Do we have a second?
I'll second.
All in favor, one at a time. Aye.
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 Meeting adjourned. Thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Are we going to leave this on for the rest of the afternoon just so we can kind of see what everybody does?
I'm going to see your dog. Yeah.
Well, Kyle's already split, so I don't know.
You
got
to bring your dog in, Jim.
Well, buddy, come here. Come here.